Welcome to Shabby Puggy Yarn Podcast. It's been quite a while, but I'm trying to just get back on the horse. This feels a little weird. I have been trying to record for several weeks, but yeah, things happen. But now I'm here, and hopefully this will be an episode I can use. So if you haven't watched this podcast before, my name is Emma, I'm a Swede living in Norway, and this is Alphonse. He's my co-host from time to time, and he loves to sleep on the Finnish objects. So, and perhaps Frank also wants to join us, since I have tried to change my setting a bit. I have been doing a lot of my recording the last year further away in the living room, but now I'm trying to adjust with lightings to see if I can just sit here. The dogs are more relaxed when I'm sitting in the sofa, and it feels more homey for me. So yeah, the bulldog is Frank. He isn't visible yet, but he's resting his head on the sofa, so maybe he will say hello later on. So yeah, it has been months and months and months since I recorded last, for a lot of reasons, and I think that I can't just talk about all the things I have been knitting during the autumn of last year, but yeah, I have been sick quite a lot with different things. So that's a lot of the reasons why I haven't been recording, but hopefully it will get better now, and I can start recording weekly or bi-weekly or something, depending on how much time I get. Hopefully this lighting setting can make it easier to record even when it's dark outside. Now the outside looks really overexposed, but it's quite dark here still. We have sunlight maybe 4 or 5 hours a day or something, maybe a little more, but most of the days it's quite cloudy and like overcast, and so the lighting isn't good inside. But I try this out, and let me know what you think. So maybe I should stop blathering about weather and camera settings. This is a crafty space, so I hope you have some nice beverage and some knitting so to work on while watching. So yeah, I won't be able to talk about all my knitted things from the autumn of 2017. I haven't been really good at taking finished object photos either, so some of the things I haven't even shared on Instagram because I haven't had the time or the energy to take the photos I need. So I figured I should just share my like finished object highlights, and for that I chose to think about in January in 2017. I talked a lot about how I wanted to how I wanted to knit more sweaters for myself. There's Frank. He also likes to sleep on the knits. So yeah, January 2017, I talked about wanting to knit sweaters for myself. I have knit several sweaters, but only like one for me in the last, or two in like 3 or 4 years. So 2017 was supposed to be my year of knitting sweaters for myself. And early in the spring I knitted the Kingston tunic by Andrea Murray. So if you have watched it before, you have probably seen it. And after that I have actually finished 3 more sweaters. So one of them is the one I'm wearing. So this is a Norwegian design called Mors Kosejense. So a mother's cozy sweater, maybe. I believe it's in English too. So this is knitted in a yarn called Puno from Rauma, I think. Yeah, good job, Emma. Don't remember the yarn name. But anyway, it's this very fluffy single ply. I bought it on a sale, and actually, I didn't have enough of the same dye lot, and since it was like on a sale, they didn't have any more in the shop. But what I did is just I alternated the skeins for the sleeves, and it's not that visible. So the sleeves are stockinette, one by one rib in the cuffs, and there's a folded neckline, and there's this one by one twisted rib in all of the body. So it's really flexible and the yarn is really warm. So yeah, it's a really cozy knit, perfect for the really cold weather. And we have had quite a chilly and cold winter here in where I live, in Norway. So we have some days with below 20, but mostly around minus 15. It's cold enough. So a cozy sweater is really perfect for that. But then I have the other two that I have finished. So one you have seen because it has been lingering and been redone several times. My Miss Sailor sweater. So this is a Pickles design, or originally it's a Pickles design. So it has quite a bat wing shape, and I started knitting it in 2016, and when I have knitted, like, I rearranged and knitted from the top down. It's originally knitted bottom up. So when I have knitted from neckline down to the armholes and tried it on, it was too skinny in the sleeves. So early 2017 I ripped back the whole thing, and I used the flax light pullover like for the stitch counts, and I used stripes for the winter sailor. So here it is. It's knitted in Pickles Merino Tweed, so it's a really, really nice purple with specks of blue and green and some pink and white. And then I have this icy bluish grey, which has specks of blue. And it's really, really nice. It's very light, so it's more like a spring and autumn sweater. But I have found this that the tweed yarn is stretching quite a lot. So the neckline is a lot bigger now than when I used it early. So I will try it on when it gets warmer. Now it's too cold to use just this. But when it's getting better, I will think about maybe like sewing some elastic on the inside of the ribbing to hold it together a bit. But it's really nice, and it got really, really soft with use and wash. So this autumn I used it quite a lot. And the alterations of using the flax light pullover pattern was really good, because that pattern is so great. It's for free, and it has a lot of sizes, so it's really, really nice. And I just eliminated the garter stripe on the sleeves that's in the flax light, and just did the stripes from the Pickles one. And the last sweater, this yarn I showed you in like the last podcast I did. Or maybe I didn't. I think I did. I went to Syfestivalen in Gothenburg with my brother in August, and I bought yarn from a lovely lady who has a company called Magasin Duet. And this is actually from the design collection from 2016. So this sweater is called Vissel. Not sure on the pronunciation, but it's quite a funny shape. but it fits really, really good. And I have been using this inside, like indoors, like whole autumn and winter. It's amazing. And the yarn is really great. It's Silke Tweed by Magazine Duet. So it's lamb's wool and silk, and it's really, really good on like regulating the temperature, because when I use like pure wool, I feel like I get overheated. I'm quite a warm person, so knitting things isn't that good of an idea, actually. But this quality of yarn is really, really great, because I don't feel too warm, but I'm not freezing. So it's a 3/4 length sleeve, even though the sleeves are really tiny, but it's like the shoulder areas go quite far out with this like bat wing design. So this was a really quick knit, because I won't give away the secret sauce, but you knit it from armpit through the front to the armpit and behind the back, and then you pick up stitches and do other things. So it's a really, really nice one. I can really recommend it, and it has a really good fit if you like a little bit of, if you like a little bit of oversized sweaters. So yeah, this is, I think, the most used sweater I have at the moment. It's really, really great. So yeah, I actually have more of this yarn in stash, but for another sweater. But yeah, that's the three sweaters, and the fourth one is the Kingston tunic. It's on the wash at the moment. I have used it quite a lot, but it has been stretching, so it's really, really long, but I like it. And then I thought I should share two other finished objects. Or no, it's three actually. But the last finished object of 2017 is one really worth sharing. I finished it between Christmas and New Year's, and I really want to share them with you because they are so amazing. So they were really, really popular on Instagram. I saw them like a week before the pattern was released, like a single pattern. It has been in a collection. And the designer is Isolde Tig, and they're called Millet or Millet mittens. I'm not sure about the pronunciation. Estonian isn't a language I speak. I will put a name down here somewhere. But yeah, I think it means love, if I'm not mistaken. But they have been in a collection by Isolde Tig, and they released them this autumn as a single pattern. So I ran to my local yarn store. I had white yarn at home, but I didn't have the dark grey or the yellow. So I got it, and they knit up so fast, and I use them a lot. It's really nice with the top, because regular like Scandinavian mittens, you do decreases on the outside and the inside. And it's quite easy to get ladders and stuff. But this is more like a beret or something, so you have a round decrease in the top. So it's really, really nice. And I actually knitted it in the original colors. It's not like me to do that. I usually want to change up it quite a bit. But I fell in love with this color combination, and they work great with my building blocks shawl. Because it's in grey and yellow. So it's really great. And the cuffs are really beautiful. And also they have on the inside a twisted rib, so you get a good grip underneath. It's one by one, yeah. And then you have this pretty decorative cuff. So it's quite a wide mitten. I was a little bit afraid it would be too short for my long fingers, but I washed them, and before I blocked them, I just put my hand in it and pulled on the top a bit, and now they're perfect. So it's a really good fit. I use them a lot. It's the perfect weather for mittens like these. And I used Rauma Finol, like the original design one and two. So I have been thinking about making another pair of these before this winter is over, but I'm not sure if I will be able to. But I love the mittens. They are really, really nice. So yeah. My last pair of finished object for 2017. And then I had my first finished object of 2018. So now we're getting more to where we're supposed to be. So this is from a Swedish designer called Erika Guselius, or she's also known as Döderjök. So this is a baby cardigan. I finished it like right after New Year's. Or I'm not finished because I still haven't gotten any buttons. So that's why you have the markers. But I have steeked it with a crochet steek. So for this little sweater I used Kauni, the rainbow yarn. It's quite a toothy wool, and it's really, really nice with the rainbow effect. So yeah, and then as a white I used a contrast from a Norwegian yarn company called Hillesvåg. I believe the yarn base is called Vilje, but I'm not sure. I will write it down, and I have also written in like my project page on Ravelry. So yeah, it needs buttons and button bands, but otherwise it's finished and it's really, really cute. So yeah. And my last finished object for this week is one that I recently finished. These socks. I started them in January, yeah. And I last weekend I was actually at a knitting camp or knitting retreat, or what you should say, and they had a knit along beforehand to get us really excited. So we're supposed to knit from Swedish designers. So this design is from Anna Bergman, Tant Ultus. I have showed you the sock book she released 1.5 years ago. It's really, really nice, but this has only been sold as a kit from the dyer, Tant Kofta. She's a yarn dyer in the west of southwest of Sweden, north from Gothenburg. But anyways, she have been like selling kits, and the original one was in a bluish turquoise color and orange and white, and this was her new colorway. I wasn't able to get like the pattern as a download, so I bought kit, ordered it home to my brother. So when I met up with him between Christmas and New Year's, I got this kit, and they knitted really, really fast, and I really like them. The colors are really home to me, so that's why it felt really good to knit it for the knitting camp, because the camp was located in Dalarna, where I'm like the area where I'm from, and they're very traditional colors. This kind of red and yellow is quite usual to have on houses where I live, or where I lived, where I grew up. So these are really like home to me in the colors, and the pattern is really amazing. I had some troubles with the heels. I'm still not used to make short row heels. I have troubles with getting them tight enough in the turning point here. Anna Bergman has a technique for doing that, and I've been trying it, and I don't get along with it. So on this pair, I made German short rows technique, but I'm thinking that maybe I should just pull in. Now it's too hot on this side, you have to change to this side. So I'm thinking about, for others of her patterns, I'm thinking about maybe just knit in a thread and do an afterthought heel in the round. Or maybe I just have to practice. But maybe if, do you have some good technique for making it not so airy in this section? It's not that bad with the German short row for me, but I still feel like it should be tighter on the heel, but I don't know. It works. The socks fit my husband, so he's happy. He was a little bit sad that I had to take them away from him because he hadn't been able to use them. I just tried him on his foot. He said, oh, this feels great. And I said, yeah, and now I need them. But now I have showed them, I can try to remember to take photographs so I can share them. Yeah. So that's my most recent finished object. I finished them last Thursday. No, Thursday 2 weeks ago. So yeah. And then I should smoothly move on to my whips. I have two. It's a little bit crazy to just have two works in progress. The first one is in a new bag. So my dear friend Solveig, known as Sørehue, she's a knitting designer, and she's also making the Norwegian knitting magazine Bladet Garn. She made me this bag for Christmas. So it's a drawstring and it's perfectly my colors. She knows me really, really well. And it's you're able to turn it inside out, and then I have another print on the inside. But I won't turn it inside out since it's full of yarn. And then I also got I got this really cool pin, which it has from Bladet Garn, and then I had to put on all my other pins so they can be in a good company. I'm really in love with my pug, my unipug and my merpug. They are really great. But I also have like a cake and avocado and a llama and stuff. So yeah, that's the bag. And first my socks moved in, and when they moved out, this design or this project moved in. So the pattern is from Pickles, the Norwegian designer team. It's an old pattern called Bråkmakergense. It's available in Norwegian and English, and it's a really, really cute baby sweater, or children's sweater maybe. The smallest size is 1 year, so that's the one I'm working on. So I'm doing it in two strands of Pickles Pure Thin Alpaca. Let's see. Oh, it's blown out. This is the trouble with new lighting. But yeah. It's from Pickles Pure Thin Alpaca. So it's 100% alpaca. And it's 185 meters on 50 grams. So I use two strands for this. And you need this really nice structured pattern. It's not a little bit more than a rib. So it's really nice to, you have to think a little bit, but not too much. So it's quite nice if you're like sitting in a waiting room or at a doctor's or something. But it's not boring because it's not just rib. So yeah, I have done quite a bit, but I still have a lot to go. I'm knitting it on 5mm needles, so it's quite quick, actually. So that's really, really nice. So yeah, that will hopefully be a finished object soon. Oh, drop my yarn. So yeah, then my other work in progress is quite close to finish. This is a sweater called Rönn. It's a Swedish pattern. Rönn is a kind of tree we have in, at least in Sweden and Norway. I haven't looked up the English translation for it, but it's a guardian. So I have knitted the body and started on the first sleeve. I knitted the bottom bands first, so they are all done. I wasn't sure about if I had enough yardage, and I figured it's better to have bottom bands and shorter sleeves than the other way around. So yeah, it's a little bit of yarn chicken, but I have started the first sleeve. So hopefully you can see, it's a little bit hard, but it's knitted with this bubbles or popcorn thingies. It's a little bit hard to see because I'm using two different strands of yarn. The original pattern used Magasin Duet mohair tweed, so it's a tweedy mohair yarn. I wasn't able to get any of it, but I looked around in my stash and I found Pickles Merino Tweed in this beetroot color. And where's the other one? Oh, dropped it too. And this silk mohair in this burgundy color. So also from Pickles. So I use one strand of each. So I get a similar fluffy texture. Mine is probably a little bit more fluffy, but I don't mind. Hopefully it will be really, really warm. So yeah, and it's quite quick to knit. I'm knitting it on 4mm needles. I got gauge spot on, so it's perfect. These bubbles or popcorns or what you call them, they were really easy to like memorize, but it also made it quicker to knit because you feel like, oh, I'm just knitting two more rows and then one row of these bubbles, and then you knit a couple of rows and then do some bubbles. So it was really, really nice. It has some shoulder or shaping in the shoulders, so it's higher up in the neckline than out in the sleeve, and it also has some shaping for a cuff. You say cuff, but I'm not sure, but like in the shoulder sleeve area you have some short rows too. And I was really impressed about the bottom bands. It's a garter bottom band, and then you apply an I-cord around the whole front. So the only alteration, except having another yarn, I have knitted mine quite a little bit longer. The original one would have been ending like right in the middle of where I'm the biggest, in the waist, or below, just below my waist, and I didn't want that, so I knitted mine 12 centimeters longer, so it just touches the hip, and I'm really pleased with that. So now I just need to knit sleeves like crazy. The sleeves are without the bubbles, they're just stockinette. But hopefully I can finish this up and start using it when the spring comes. And I believe it will be really awesome. It's fluffy and warm. So yeah, that's my work in progress. So yeah, that's all about the knitting and stuff. As you can see, we're just having a really chill time here. I hope that the dog's snoring isn't too disturbing. They are snoring quite a bit when they are like lying on the backs in the sofa. I'm so used to it, so I don't think about it that much. But I think that my microphone isn't picking up too much. I hope so. Otherwise, if you have any opinions or advice, if you want to like for my setting, or if you like the lighting as it is now and the setting here, or if I should move back to my bookshelf and record there as I did last year, feedback is always welcome. If you have any tips on how to make better tight short row heels, I'm gladly to take advice. So yeah. Otherwise here it's quite chill. We're just waiting for the winter to pass so we can go out and enjoy some sunshine again. It's getting quite a bit lighter now in February and it feels great. I have been able to go out on walks more and it's really nice. And it's not like it's dark when I go to work and it's dark when I go home. Now it's a little bit lighter in the afternoon, so that's really nice. Yeah. So otherwise, the only thing I need to tell you guys before ending this podcast is the big news that will change quite a lot of things in 2018 for this family and for us. Is that I am expecting a baby. It's really, really nice and we're really happy about it. I'm feeling great. So it's a crazy experience. It really, really is. So if you follow me on Instagram, you have probably seen the picture I've posted. But I wanted to share it to you on the podcast as well. So yeah, since I'm feeling really great, I hope that I can just jump back on and podcasting, so you will probably see more baby knits and baby sewing in the coming months. I really, really hope so, because I want to share it with you and I want to podcast because I feel great about doing it now when I'm back on the horse. So yeah, I don't know what else to say. I'm just really, really happy about it. We have wanted to expand the family for a long time, and now it's hopefully the right time to do it for us. So yeah, just trying to relax in it and enjoy the time being. So yeah, I think that is all for today. And hopefully I will see you next weekend again. So please share any comments you have on YouTube or in my Ravelry group. And I really, really hope you have a really good weekend, week or weekend, and that we will see each other soon again. Bye!